See, today we have to start. Sunil, can you please mute yourself?
Sir,
Yeah, Sunil.
I'm Himsela, sir.
Yeah, Himsela, tell me.
When I'm doing the practice of when I assign a company code to the company, it is showing an error message like it is showing the error message the entry 2810 RJ does not exist in T880. It is showing, sir.
One second. I'm just logging into the system. You are assigning company code to company, right?
Yes,
What's your company code?
2810.
2810. RJ Electronics, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is your company?
RJ Electronics, sir.
No. Company name. What is the identification you have given in the first step? If you press on F4,
F4. Not able to.
so your group is not there. You did not define the group.
Okay. Could you please show me this?
How to create a group, huh?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay. See, SPRO, enterprise structure, definition, financial accounting, define company. So this is the first step in your material, Himasailija. This one.
Yes, sir.
So you did
Yeah.
not do this step, it seems. Straight away, you have gone to step number 1.2. Okay.
Okay.
So, what
You
is
know, sir, I have to, no, sir, I did that 1.1 also I did, sir.
and what is the identification? What is the identification you have given for the company?
RJ Group, I gave it as
No,
RJ Group of.
no. That is company name. Company identification I am talking about.
2510, 2810 only, sir.
2810.
Yes, sir.
Then RJ Group, right?
Yeah.
City New York, country US, language EM, currency USD. Click on save. See, it did not create. Otherwise, you might have forgotten, right? So, if you have created, the system should have given this error message and entry already exists the same key.
Okay, 2810, sir. I gave 2810 as the data.
You
Two
want?
eight one zero RJ I gave.
Okay. Let me check. 2810 RJ.
RJ group.
This is also useful for others also, right? Sometimes you may get these errors because sometimes you might have forgotten to save the objects. This was also not there because it was saved now. The thing is, you might have forgotten. That's only the reason. You might have forgotten to save. You have given
Okay.
all the information, but you might have forgotten to click on save. That is the reason why it is not able to find it there. Now, in the assignment,
Okay, sir.
yeah, one second, I will show you. In assignment, now you can find it. So, if you do press on your F4, you can see your company there now. See, 2810 RG group of companies. Right? Then
Yes, sir.
you can see here, just now you have created, no? That you can see here.
Yes, sir.
In the previous case, you might have forgotten to click on save. Nothing else.
Okay.
ERC2810RJ. Two companies we have created, no? These two companies we can see here. Yeah. Now, coming to the current topic. Jerisha, please mute yourself. I mean, Himasalicha. Yeah. See, definition of tolerance groups for GL accounts. So first I will explain the concept of tolerance groups for GL accounts. See, tolerance groups for GL accounts, setting the maximum limits equal to which or below which the differences in the balance sheet GL accounts are automatically taken to the profit and loss account or some predefined account like sundry balance or written off account. Again, I'm repeating, observe it carefully. Setting the maximum limits equal to which or below which the differences in the balance sheet GL accounts are automatically taken to the profit and loss account or some predefined account like sundry balances written off account. Means, so before going to understand the tolerance group for GL accounts, we have to understand one more concept, open items. Open means pending. Open items means pending items. So this pending item concept is applicable to vendor accounts, customer accounts, and some balance sheet GL accounts. So what is the concept of open items for vendor accounts? Open means pending items, I told you. So today we purchase a material from a vendor and he has given 30 days credit. So when do we make the payment to vendor on this invoice? On 30th day. So till you make the payment to vendor on this invoice, the system will display this purchase invoice in the red color, informing you that this invoice is pending for payment. That is called open item. Now, on 30th day, we have made the payment to vendor. Then the system will turn this red color invoice into green color. That is called cleared item. So I will show you the open item and cleared items relating to vendors in accounts payable. Then coming to open items to customer accounts. Today we sold some goods to a customer and we have given 15 days credit. So obviously the customer makes the payment on 15th day. So till you receive the payment from the customer on this invoice, the system will display this invoice in the red color again, which is called open item. So this is the information to the user that we have sold goods to the customer on this invoice and we have not yet received the payment. That invoice is pending for receipt. So open means basically pending. So when we receive the payment from the customer on 15th day, the system will turn that invoice into green color. That is called cleared item. So again, I will show you the open item and cleared item relating to customers in accounts receivables. At this point of time, we have to understand the concept of open items relating to GL accounts. So this concept of open item is not applicable to all the GL accounts. It is applicable to some of the balance sheet GL accounts. What are those balance sheet GL accounts? Outstanding expense account, outstanding incomes account, prepaid expense account, incomes received in advance account. So these are the four GL accounts to which this open item concept is applicable. Means what? Here, let me change the date. 10th October. Now, here we always follow the concept of accrual accounting. So what is the accrual concept of accounting? What is the accrual concept of accounting? Here, the main purpose of accounting system is to find the business results, right? So periodically, how much profit you have done, how much profit you have earned, that is the purpose of accounting system. So every month we want to find the profit. So how do we find the profit every month? We have to compare the revenues of the month with the expenses of that month. Then only we can find whether we have incurred profit or whether we have incurred loss. So, in order, again I am repeating, in order to find the profit in a particular month, we have to compare the revenues of that month with the expense of that month. Then only we can find profit or loss. But there are some expenses which are incurred in the current month but paid in the next month. There are some expenses which are incurred in the current month but paid in the next month. Now, for example, you take September. September rent is paid on 1st of October. October rent is paid on 1st of November. Similarly, let us assume that the salaries are paid on 1st of every month. In that case, salaries of October are paid on 1st of November and the salaries of November are paid on 1st of December and so on. Okay, let us assume that we are preparing P&L account as on 31st October 2017. So as on that 2017, 31st October, we have incurred salaries, we have incurred rent, but as on 31st October, we did not pay. So when you are paying these expenses on 1st November, so when you pay these expenses in 1st November, if you account them on 1st November, what exactly it is meaning? The expenses of October are considered in the month of November. So in that case, if you prepare the P&L account for the month of October, it does not show correct picture of the profit because the expense related to October are accounted in the month of November. That's why as on 31st October, for these expenses which have been incurred but not paid, you post some entries. Those entries are called accrual entries. So we discuss again elaboratedly regarding this accrual entries at the end of the general ledger accounting. So here on 31st October 2017, I am preparing the P&L account and balance sheet. So there are some expenses which are incurred but not paid. Let us say rent, salaries and commission. So then we post the entry rent account debtor 10,000, salaries account debtor. No, here rent is incurred on 31st October, but it is not paid on 31st October. It is paid on 1st of November. So similarly, salaries were incurred. You have used the services of your employees, but as on 31st October, you did not pay salaries. They are paid on 1st of November. Means the salaries of October are paid on 1st of November and are accounted in the November. Then the salaries of October are not considered in the salaries of October in the month of October, right? That's why if you prepare a P&L account for October, it will not show correct picture of the profit. Clear, Sunil? Yeah. Now, so in order to recognize these expenses in the month of October itself, we post some entries. These entries are called accrual entries. Say rent account debtor 10,000. If you are paying some expenses of the current month and the next month, I am talking, right? Generally, you receive salaries on the 31st or 30th, right? Just to make you understand the concept, I have taken this example. So we have incurred rent account, salaries account and commission account, but they are not paid as on 31st October. That's why we post one entry debiting rent account 10,000, salaries account 20,000, commission account 5,000. But did you pay them? No. So there is no concept of cash here. They are debited to outstanding expense account. So if you prepare the outstanding expense account, they are posted to the credit side of outstanding expense account. It seems that somebody has not muted. Anil, can you please mute yourself? Anil, can you please mute yourself? So, by virtue of this entry, by rent 10,000, by salaries 20,000, by commission 5,000. So these three line items are posted to credit side. Did you pay these expenses? No, they are pending for payment now. So system will display these three line items in the red color, which is called open item. Clear? Now, on 1st October 2017, you have paid the above expenses. Then we debit outstanding expense account. Then two cash rent 10,000, two cash salaries 20,000, two cash commission 4,800. So according to this entry, if you post these items into the outstanding expense account, they are posted to the debit side. So two cash account rent, two cash salaries 20,000, two cash commission 4,800. And these items are paid items, right? So these items are displayed in green color, which is called cleared item. So this is the concept of open items and cleared items. Now, again, on 30th November 2017, I am preparing the P&L account and balance sheet. Again, I am preparing the P&L account and balance sheet. In that case, you balance this outstanding expense account. On 30th November 2017, you balance this outstanding expense account. What is the total credit balance? What is the total credit side? 35,000. But the debit side is only 34,800. So there is a difference of 200 rupees. Let us assume the difference is in rupees. This is the rupee account. Okay. So there is a difference of 200 rupees. Because the total credit is 35,000, but the total debit is only 34,800 rupees. So there is a difference of 200 rupees. Now, on 30th November 2017, we are preparing the P&L account and balance sheet. In that case, where do we display this 200 rupees difference? Whether in the P&L account or balance sheet? I hope everybody is clear with the question. I am not asking you the answer. What I mean to say is, well, did you understand the concept till now? If anybody wants, just put the message, I will explain again. Okay, perfect. So where do we display this difference of 200 rupees? Whether in the P&L account or balance sheet? It depends upon the reason of this difference. I will tell you two reasons. The person to whom you have provided commission, actually you have provided commission 5,000, but you paid only 4,800. That is the reason why there is a difference. So the person to whom you have provided commission, he came to our office on 1st November exactly at 4:55 evening time. Our closing hours are 5 o'clock. So by that time, the main cashier already has left the office. And I am the junior cashier. And at that time, I have only 4,800 rupees. So the commission agent approached me. Then I said, sir, I am having only 4,800 rupees. And the main cashier also has left the office today. Something little bit early. So instead of coming for next day, right? You do one thing. Take this 4,800 rupees. Okay. And you collect the remaining 200 rupees when you come next time to our company. Obviously, it looks very logical. So, the commission agent has agreed. So, I have paid 4,800 rupees to him. So, for this difference of 200 rupees, the commission agent did not turn up to our company till 30th November. He may come in future. But as on 30th November, he has not yet come to our company for collecting after 200 rupees. That's why still there is a balance of 200 rupees. If this is the reason for this 200 rupees, still, there is a liability on our company to make the payment of this 200 rupees whenever the commission agent comes to office. If that is the reason, it is a liability. In that case, it has to be displayed on the liability side of the balance sheet. I hope it's clear for everybody. One more reason I will tell you. The person to whom you have provided commission, he said, sir, in this particular transaction, I am giving you in this particular transaction, please remember, in this particular transaction, I am giving you a discount of 200 rupees. Then I felt very happy and I said, okay. So instead of 5,000, I paid only 4,800 rupees. This is the reason for this difference. If this is the reason for this difference, you need not pay, right? It is actually cash discount received. Means it is the revenue. In that case, this difference of 200 rupees is to be transferred to P&L account as revenue. Clear? So based upon the reason for this difference, you may have to transfer it to P&L account or balance sheet. So if you prepare the P&L account and balance sheet manually, as a human being, you know the reason for this difference. As an accountant, you know the reason for this difference. Based upon the reason, you can decide whether it has to be transferred to P&L account or balance sheet. But here, the system itself will prepare the P&L account and balance sheet in SAP. In that case, how the system knows that whether it has to be transferred to P&L account or balance sheet? For that, so how the system knows that whether this has to be transferred to P&L account or balance sheet? For that, we give the instruction to the system with the help of the tolerance groups for GL accounts. See what I written here. Setting the maximum limits equal to which or below which the differences in the balance sheet GL accounts are automatically taken to the profit and loss account or some predefined account like sundry balance written off account. So exactly what we do is, in consultation with the accounts department, we set up the different tolerance groups. For each tolerance group, we set up the upper limit. And these upper limits, we cannot decide on our own. We have to take into consideration the requirements of the accounts department. For example, let us assume that we have defined four tolerance groups. Tolerance group A. It's not the miscellaneous receipts, right? Cash discount received or sundry balance written off account. Or you can also take it to miscellaneous accounts. Or you can also take it to miscellaneous receipts account. No issues. Based upon your requirement, it can be transferred to miscellaneous revenues account or miscellaneous expense accounts or cash discount received account or sundry balance written off account. Any account based upon your requirement, accounting requirement, you can take it. Now, in this case, we have defined four tolerance groups. Group A, 150. Group B, 100. Group C, 200. Group D, 250. Now, if you assign, for example, if you assign tolerance group A in the outstanding expense account master record, at the time of creating the GL accounts, we assign the tolerance groups. Where do we assign? I will show you at the time of creating GL accounts in the general ledger accounting. No, miscellaneous expenses and sundry expenses are same, Chandrasekhar. And see the question posted by Chandrasekhar. Miscellaneous expenses and sundry expenses are same now, or there is any difference? No, both are same. Okay, Chandrasekhar. Now, Gadi. If we face 4,800 out of 500, 200 will be remains as open item only. Yes, exactly. Right, Gadi. So out of 5,000, he has paid only 4,800 rupees. In that case, 200 difference will be shown as open item. Now we are going to discuss how this open item is to be treated. So after creating this tolerance group A, we have assigned the tolerance group A in the outstanding expense account, let us assume. Then what is the difference in the GL account? 200 rupees. And what is the upper limit of the tolerance group? 150. So in that case, the difference is more than the upper limit. Then the difference is transferred to balance sheet as liability. But if you assign tolerance group D, the difference is less than upper limit. In that case, the difference is transferred to P&L account as revenue. Let us come in the reverse way. It is the policy of the company that in any balance sheet GL account, if the difference is equal to 200 rupees or less than 200 rupees, straight away transfer it to P&L account. In that case, we assign either group C or group D in the outstanding expense account. Clear? That's how, with the help of the tolerance groups for the GL accounts, we can control whether the residual balances or the closing balances in this type of ledger accounts are to be transferred to P&L account or balance sheet. And anytime we can change the tolerance groups in the outstanding expense account. So this is the concept of tolerance groups for GL accounts. See, based on the requirements of the accounting department, we define different tolerance groups and we assign them in the respective GL account master records. Based on the limits specified in those tolerance limits, the differences in the GL account is automatically transferred to profit and loss account. Means, if the difference in the GL account is less than the upper limit of the tolerance group, the difference is transferred to P&L account. If the difference is more than the upper limit of the tolerance group, then that is transferred to either balance sheet or, that is transferred to balance sheet, either onto the liability side or asset side, based on the debit balance it is or credit balance it is. Then, the limits are applied at account level, not for every transaction level in that GL account. Means, the system will consider the difference in the total of the account, not for every transaction level. That system will consider the difference at the account level, not at the transaction level. Then, a tolerance group can be assigned in any number of GL account master records. But a GL account master record can be assigned with only one tolerance group. The upper limits can be specified either for debit differences or for credit differences separately. You cannot define the prepaid expenses. Prepaid expenses we will discuss in the accrual concept of accounting, right? It is little bit early to discuss this concept of prepaid expenses. We have the separate topic on this accrual expenses, deferral expenses later on. At that time, you can clearly understand. The upper limits can be specified either for debit differences or for credit differences separately. We can define upper limits either in terms of whole amounts or in terms of percentages or both. If both the terms are defined, the system will consider the lower of the two as upper limit and behaves accordingly. It's very, very crucial point. See, we can define the upper limits either in the terms of whole amounts or in terms of percentages or both. If both the terms are defined, the system will consider the lower of the two as upper limit and behaves accordingly. Means, for example, tolerance group A, 150 rupees. This is called whole amount. Or we can specify the percentage, like 1%. So you can define the upper limit either as whole amount or percentage or both. Suppose for tolerance group A, right, we have defined that the upper limit is 150 and 1%. Both the terms you have defined. So the system will apply 1% on the total of the account. So what is the total of the account? 35,000. 10,000 plus 20,000 plus 5,000, 35,000. On 35,000, 1% is 350. Out of these two figures, which one is lower? 150. So the system considers that the upper limit of the tolerance group is 150. Then the system compares the difference in the GL account with the tolerance group limit 150. So difference is more than 150 and that will be transferred to balance sheet. So this is the concept of tolerance group. And please remember, we can define any number of tolerance groups and these upper limits we cannot decide on our own. We have to take into consideration the requirements of the management. Management means here, we are accounts, finance and accounts department, right? So this is the concept of tolerance groups for GL accounts. I hope the concept is clear to everybody. If anybody wants any time, I will explain again. Any point, I will explain again. and see the material. SPRO, financial accounting. See the path, please. Financial accounting, general ledger accounting, business transactions, open item clearing, clearing differences, define tolerance groups for GL accounts. Transaction code is not there. Add the transaction code. OBA0. Transaction code OBA0. See here, if you know the path, we can find the transaction code. Did I tell you this technique in the class? If you know the path, we can find the transaction code. Did I tell you this technique in the path? How to? Okay, I will tell you. First, let us do the step, then again, I will tell you. Continue. Transaction code OBA0. Transaction code OBA0. Click on new entries and don't write, first look at the screen. I want to define the tolerance group AB like this, right? How to define? First, just look at the screen. Company code 3366, right? Tolerance group A. Please don't write tolerance group A. Description, upper limit 100. Then see tolerances for groups of GL accounts in local currency. Debit posting 100. Credit posting 100. If you want to define percentage also, you can define the percentages here. Click on save. Then I want to define B again. Click on next entry button. Company code 3366. Tolerance group B. Upper limit 150. Debit posting 150. Credit posting 150. Again, if you want to define any percentage, that percentage can be defined here. Click on save. Click on next entry button. Company code 3366. Tolerance group C. Here you can use up to 4 characters. For each tolerance group, you can use up to 4 characters ID. Just like that, I'm using single character. So in that way, you can define any number of tolerance groups. Right? Now continue in the material. Now you can write in the material. Company code is equal to 3366. Company code is equal to 3366. Tolerance group blank means keep that field blank. Don't write anything there. I will tell you what is this and why is this. Tolerance group is equal to blank means keep that field as blank. Then name is equal to blank tolerance group for 3366. Blank tolerance group for 3366. Now something is missing there. Write down. Debit posting is equal to 1000. These two fields are missing there. Debit posting is equal to 1000. Credit posting is 1000. Debit posting is equal to 1000. Credit posting is 1000. Click on save. Now, what is the blank tolerance group, right? Here you have some space, no? Please write down here itself. The blank tolerance group is also called the blank tolerance group is also called null tolerance group. Null, NULL, null tolerance group. The blank tolerance group The blank tolerance group is applicable to the blank tolerance group is applicable to all the GL accounts. The blank tolerance group is applicable to all the GL accounts which are not assigned with any tolerance group, which are not assigned with any tolerance group. Means, suppose for example, you did not assign any tolerance group in the GL account. So in that case, the values of this tolerance group are applicable. So in addition to required number of tolerance groups, generally we also define the blank tolerance group in the implementation. Now, the next one is tolerance groups for employees. This we will see in tomorrow's class. But before that, here, for example, see, for the step number 7.1, tolerance groups for GL accounts, I have given the path, but I did not give the transaction code. I told you, for every screen, there is a path and there is a transaction code. So, I have given only path, but I did not give the transaction code. In that case, actually transaction code is OBA0. I told you to write the transaction code, right? OBA0. So, if you know the path, we can find the transaction code. How to do that? Please write down in the notes. Put heading note. If the path is given, we can find the transaction code. If the path is given, we can find the transaction code. For example, to find the transaction code, for definition of tolerance groups, for GL accounts. Procedure. Execute the path. For definition of tolerance groups. Execute the path for definition of tolerance groups. Like, write the path. SPRO, financial accounting, general ledger accounting, SPRO, financial accounting, general ledger accounting, business transactions, open item clearing, clearing differences, define tolerance groups for GL accounts. Means, first you have to execute this path, define tolerance groups for GL accounts. So here also I'm executing the path. SPRO, Financial Accounting, General Ledger Accounting, Business Transactions, Open Item Clearing, Clearing Differences. So you came to the last line in the path. So you have to come to the last line in the path. Different tolerance goes for GL accounts. Okay. Now continue. Go to menu. Additional information. Again, additional information two times. Go to menu, additional information, again additional information, display key, IMG activity, display key, IMG activity. Again, I'm repeating, just look at the screen. After coming to the last line in the path, go to menu, additional information. Again, additional information. Then, display key, IMG activity. So when you click on like that, the system will add something for every line, right? Now keep the cursor against the activity. For which the transaction code is required. For which the transaction code is required. Look at the screen. Here, define tolerance rules for GL accounts. For this only, I require transaction code, right? Keep the cursor here. The last four letters is transaction codes. The last four letters is the transaction code. Look at the screen. The last four letters means in this case OBA0. That's why I told you the transaction code is OBA0. Continue. This procedure is applicable only in IMG screen. This is one technique, right? Now, Anil has posed one question. Suppose if the tolerance range is lower than the open items at the time, how it shows, for example, you are defining GL tolerance group 400, 500, 600, 700, okay. But actually the open item will be 2000. See, if the open item is more than the upper limit, that will be transferred to balance sheet. If the difference in the GL account is more than the upper limit, that is the open item, is more than the upper limit of the tolerance group, Anil, that will be transferred to balance sheet. If it is the credit balance, it will be transferred to liability side. If it is the debit balance, that will be transferred to assets. Okay, all right. Now, Akhila, you have any questions? Okay. Anil. By tomorrow, our basic settings will be over. From day after tomorrow, we start general ledger accounting. Chandrasekhar. Okay, Teja. Okay. Gadilingam. Any questions?
Sir, I have a question.
Tell me.
In the account groups, you have told that it controls the fields.
Yes.
Will it controls?
Yes.
Like only field status of groups only will control, right?
No. See, the field status for master records. There are two types of field status in SAP. Field status for document entry. Field status for master records. Field status for master records is controlled by account groups. Field status for document entry is controlled by field status variant. But how the account groups control the field status for GL master records? I did not explain you this concept. This I will show you at the end of the general ledger accounting. Then only you will understand.
Okay.
Yeah.
And sir, while practicing, server is disconnecting. It's suddenly lagging out.
See, if you keep the server 10 minutes idle, right, without doing any practice.
Sir, to post all the this GL accounts and all, it will take minimum 5. If you practice continuously also, it will be breaking.
No, actually, there may be a problem with your internet, because since 1 hour we have been doing the class now in the same server. See, it's not disconnecting.
Okay.
Maybe problem sometimes from the internet.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Hima Sailija, you have any questions? Okay. Khalid, any questions?
No, sir. I am fine.
Yeah. Manoj?
I am good.
Yeah. I have seen your mail, Manoj. I will do it.
Okay, sure. Thanks.
Roni, any questions? Okay. Srinivas?
How we consolidate two company codes?
This we will discuss later on. It's a separate module. Consolidation is not a module. It cannot be explained now, right? It takes another 30 days to explain the consolidation. At this point of time, don't go for the consolidation.
Okay.
So actually, it is the part of enterprise control. There is one more module, enterprise control. So the consolidation is a separate submodule in the consolidation, in the enterprise control. Lot of settings are to be done for the consolidation. That's why I told you, Anil, right? Don't do the practice while I am explaining the class. Not only for Anil, it's my request to everybody is, don't do the practice simultaneously with me in the class. Don't do the practice simultaneously with me in the class. First listen to the explanation. Once the class is over, then you can do the practice. I will tell you. See the message posted by Anil. Whenever I open some screens, it shows the screen is locked by Lakshman. I will tell you why it is coming and how it can be resolved. Before that, Sunil, you have any questions?
No.
Okay. See, here we have opened the screen tolerance group GL accounts, right? Now, I'm trying to open one more screen. I'm trying to open the same screen again. Already we have opened tolerance groups for GL accounts. Again, I'm trying to open the same screen. Let us see what happens. This is the message you are getting, Anil, right? Here, what happens is, when several users are trying to access the same screen, the system will give the access to the screen to the first user only. For the subsequent users, I request everybody to mute yourselves, because I'm getting a lot of disturbance. Not only me, others also feel disturbance in the class. Sunil, can you please mute yourself? Sunil, can you please mute yourself? Yeah, thank you. So this screen is displayed to the subsequent user. When several users or multiple users are trying to access the same screen, the system will give the access to the screen only for the first user. For the subsequent user, the system will give this message. So the data is locked by user Lakshman and can be displayed only. Do you want to display locked data? If you click on yes, you don't have the new entries button. See? So you don't do anything. You can only display the data. In that case, you have to unlock the screens. Right? So how to unlock the screens? Write down. Again, go back to notes. Put heading note. When the message within inverted commas write down this, the data is locked by user so and so means the data is locked by so and so. Write some hyphens there. And can be displayed only. Inverted commas closed is shown by the system. We have to unlock the screen. Procedure. Click yes on the message. Go to the transaction code SM12. Username is equal to. Enter the name of the user. By whom the screen was locked. Means, for example, you got the message that the screen was locked by Tafiq, right? In that case, in the SM12 transaction code, you have to enter that username. Suppose if you get the message that the screen was locked by Manoj, in that case, in the username field, you have to enter the Manoj. Okay, now continue. Go to menu lock entry list. So this is the menu bar, lock entry list. Again, write down. Go to menu lock entry, delete all. Delete lock entries? Yes. Click yes on the message. Continue. Close the performance assistant screen. close the performance assistant screen. See, look at the screen. This screen is called performance assistant, right? You close this screen. Click on this, right? Now you will be able to access the screen now. So this happens when multiple users are trying to access the same screen, but it does not happen in the real time, because in the real time, based on the roles of the users, the respective screens are given to access to the users. But in the training class, number of students are accessing the same server, right? And they may be practicing simultaneously. That is the reason why for the first user, the system will give the access of the screen. For the second user, it gives this message. In that case, you have to execute transaction code SM12 and you have to follow the procedure. I hope everything is clear for today. Okay then, see you tomorrow same time. Good night and good day.